MONSUNO launch. MONSUNO combat. Hey guys, it's Pok'emon here. This is going to be my MONSUNO video review of the whole gameplay franchise and series and how it's played and all. So as you may have noticed, my last live game stream was Super Smash Brothers for Wii U and now I guess it would be a perfect time for me to do something else for change. I guess that would be this game right here, which I'm about to present me with. So, MONSUNO doesn't have why battle in these things called cores, and they spin around in circles that I just previously demonstrated to you right now, and it's how they battle. It's like a turn-based strategy skill game of skill, and it combines a little bit of Beyblade with Pokemon, but other than that, it mostly focuses on the elements of Yu-Gi-Oh! And Pokemon. Not so much on the spinning concept, but, well, maybe on the spinning concept, but, anyway, so, yeah, there's that. So, now, here's what I have so far, in my collection. I have these, the stock clip, and two, MONSUNO's and cores from Cortex. Oh, no, I did Eclipse organization. And of course I have these two are Shadow Poison Wing and Quick Force. Quick Force is in an Eclipse core because I don't know where's the real core is for Cortex. But anyways, so yeah. And then there's Boost, which is used by Dax in the anime. Of course, you might want to check that out sometime if you so choose to. And Locke, he's my main MONSUNO right here. If you'll notice, each MONSUNO has like I know you can't see it on the camera very well, but each MONSUNO has a little number. This guy just so you know, has 60 power points, and I'll go over that in a quick second, how that gets into play. Now, Longfang, right here, he has 20, but, and then I have an extra lock, because I lost my other charger, the Jinja's MONSUNO. Yeah, I know, the only girl on the team, and yet, still. Oh well. Yeah, but anyways, long story short, it didn't end well, but in return, I did find this in my old collection, of course. So, anyways, so yeah. And then you got these three strike launchers right here, this one is the one that Chase Zuno uses when it is given to him from his father, Dirty Zuno, and technically it's the only way to start a great beginning if you want to get a great launch and to attack the spinner. So anyways, and they also come in yellow and black and blue and white. So, but this one is my personal favorite, but it's lights up red still, nevertheless. Well, okay, so now moving on to the gameplay. Okay, so the gameplay is gonna go something like this. first you gotta choose your MONSUNO, and the person you're gonna, and another player has to choose their MONSUNO, which they're gonna battle you with. And, okay, so let's say I'm going to go with, of course, my favorite, as always, Locke. So, I need to load him up into his core right now, because he's out of his core. And, nope, he's not going in there. Okay, alright, hold on. Hold on one moment, please. Okay, alright, now you can see he's in his core, so right now, now, of course, if you haven't figured it already, the way this game is played is by one person spins their core onto the launch zone, and another player has to strike it down. It's called attacking and defending. So, now, I shall provide another demonstration for you, since the last one was inadequate. And since I went too fast probably for the camera, anyway, but anyways, okay, so yeah, come on. All right, so now,
who are you talking to?
Oh, I'm making a video
for mommy.
Okay, I know, mom.
Sore throat.
Oh yeah, and before I forget, so, I just want to remind you that these cell clips not only hold MONSUNO cores, but they also hold cards inside them as well. The reason why I'm using Redkai cards is because, these ones, the attack cards, are good for using them as a life counter card, so you know how much you start out with, and you can pick any card that you put in there, and like, yeah, so you use it to battle. So anyway, so there's that, and also of course if you saw my other Redkai Judo tutorial video, you probably recognize that there's not just red, but there's also blue and green Redkai attack cards. And as you might notice, as you probably guessed, green goes with Storm, red goes with Eclipse, and blue goes with Cortec. Yeah. But I'm mainly using Cortec because the leader of Tamed Cortec, Chase Suno, he is actually, well, kind of my favorite, but I even dress up as him. So, but anyways, moving on to the main important part of this video, is the battle. So, let's see, okay, so I'm using Locke. I'll use that Magma Minions card. Oh yeah. And what something that they introduced in Comet Chaos is the second scene of MONSUNO. I'm just gonna go ahead of myself, yeah. And is this the MONSUNO Comet does? No one knows for sure what it does, but I think if my estimation is correct, it's supposed to put it on the field, like peel it off right here. And put it on the field, and it'll increase the friction of the battle capacity. So, yeah. it's not like the MONSUNO is going to be sliding out of the launch zone, and then land in different places at once, destroying the whole place you're battling in. But hey, we can still dream. Okay. Yeah, it's not Combat Chaos exactly, literally, but if it were, you would be the first to know. Anyways, so, with that in mind, I guess we can now put this Combat Chaos combat disc on, like, here. I just like to put it there for some reason. Not that it matters anyway. But, okay, that's not going on. Come on. Get on there. Ah. Oh, yeah. By the way, big thanks to, a shout out to all the YouTube channels I've subscribed. So, Bonus Samurai, NPR Toys, Dawson Rider, Shuki, Shinobi, and Afi-san Reverie, and all the other guys, you know who you are. It's gonna be possible without your influence. Okay, so, yeah, and now, let's get on to the, let's get on to the game itself. Okay, and now we're going to need to see who is going to attack first. And let's see. Okay, just delete this. Yeah, boogie board right here. Long story short, I got it from Walgreens. Cost me like $15. But anyway, yeah, so. Okay, alright. Enough of my ranting on. Let's actually play the game. Now, I think I'll go with battling against Longfang. Alright. As for who's been first, well, let Longfang be the guest of honor. And yes, okay, alright. Lock and load. Lock and load. Yeah, you can just pick it up like that. And okay. Whoops. I gotta spin first. Okay, alright. Now watch this. Watch carefully. Okay. Monsuno. Launch. Monsuno. Hold on. That wasn't right. Monsuno. Combat. No, Monsuno launch. Monsuno combat. Well. That probably didn't count. Hold on. Monsuno launch. Monsuno combat. And you can see the log has jumped out of his core. So that means he does, as I already memorized his power points, he does 60 damage to the Longfang. Which is, okay, yeah. So that was supposed to be in defense position. Yeah, that's how you keep track, by the way. But if you have the real Monsuno cards, it should make things a lot more easier for you. Okay, so I was saying this is easy already, but that's my son on the background. I'm breaking that. Dr. Pepper.
It's a sweet one.
Yeah. Okay, I got the commercials like that. Okay, anyway. So now let's see. Okay, so you subtract like 60 from 350 and that would be 290. Yeah, my right is not exactly accurate, so, well, I mean, not exactly. Yeah, I'm just normally a good writer. Okay, well, okay. So that was turn one. That was Longfang's first turn. So now, we're on to phase two. Okay, as you can see now, I'm the one who's attacking, because that's my, so now, I loaded Lock already into a strike launcher, and now Longfang is going to spin into battle. He's going to be defending, actually, so, He's on defense, I'm on offense. Okay, alright, what more do you want? Okay, now... Now, since I'm actually going to... It's been a long painted battle. Okay. Now... Oops, gotta get my... strike launcher here. Anyway, and... Now, ready, set... MONSUNO. Launch! MONSUNO combat! Well,
I did more damage,
actually. Now, so that's. So I can say for myself, actually, I did 60 damage, and that was. That works high. Okay, alright. Now a lot has 290 life points left as well.
And we are tied.
Now let me do something as an example just to show you. Okay, so. Okay, so I've I have switched log back to a return log back to its core and now, let's see, okay, so, now, as you have, about the example I was gonna give you, so, now, just in case, these are the life size, like, let's say, you're using lock, right here, and, the problem is using lock, like, if you have a lot more life points than, or health points, what do you call them, than your opponents, then all you have to do is one final combat, is all I call it, and then, let me show you right now as an example. Final combat. Alright, and now watch this. Alright. MONSUNO. Dude. MONSUNO. Watch. MONSUNO. Combat. Booyah! And, as I should have mentioned before, earlier, when both, if one MONSUNO pops out, they just use their power points as damage to the defending MONSUNO. But if both of them pop out, that's maximum damage. And you apply any and all power points that are on both of those MONSUNO as effective damage to the MONSUNO. And you have, and of course, you, as you probably may have guessed, you must have some way to keep score of your life, of you and your opponent's life, health, whatever, points, because right now, see, whereas now I inflicted, like, 70, was this, no, like, 80 points of damage, so now he is negative 50 points of damage, and that is a T. TKO, as you may have guessed. And so now, that means I won. So, but however, if your opponent does the same thing to you first before you can do it to him or her, well then, game over for you. But yeah. So, there's that. Okay, so that was MONSUNO in a nutshell, and I don't have much gear at the time for MONSUNO, but But they do have more on, more of us online. If anything, you can try looking for the gear on at 99 cent store. Right now it is currently like the day after Black Friday, and things are getting quite hectic during these holiday times. But I cannot, and I have no way of supplying these links as to where you might find them, but I can tell you this. I have found them on Amazon and eBay, and there's plenty of other sites, I'm pretty sure, but you have to look it up yourself. So, but anyway, so this game is all in all worth playing. It is probably the only game worth playing, and mind you, this game is very challenging and fun. It's quite the combination that will appeal to any and all gamers and all board game players and anybody who's a fan of games in general. Well, almost everyone, just not the people who are old-fashioned, but anyways, no offense to those people, but this is probably worth looking into somewhere in the future or somewhere in the present. The past is another country. And, anyways, well, yeah, that was my review and gameplay walkthrough or summary of Monsuno in general. And you can check out the first season of Monsuno at dubbedanime.net. And, and thank you guys for watching. So, have a happy holidays. And this is Klutzman Amon signing out.